Welcome back, everyone. Hello, my name is Diana, and welcome to Rockin Rockfish New Year's Eve here at the Seattle Aquarium. We're glad to have you back. This year, well, a lot of changes have happened, a lot going on, a lot of construction. We've got our ocean pavilion outside being built up from the bottom on up. It's looking bigger and better every day. We have changes inside the aquarium. We have a new vet clinic now. We have a brand newly renovated bird exhibit. It's so wonderful for our diving birds. And just a lot of changes down here on the waterfront. So really cool to see everything developing. And before we go on any further with the beginning of our celebration today, I just want to do a shout out to Jasmine, my co-host from last year. Hey Jasmine, we're sorry we're missing you today. We wish you could be here. We'll dance together soon. But without any ado, check it out. We have a full band this year.
Hey.
Hi, Mikey. How
hey.
You doing?
Good. How are you doing?
Who do we have here?
Well, so I'm Mikey the Rad Scientist, and we've put together a band this year that we're calling Mikey and the Rad Scientists. And we've got a couple awesome rad scientists here. I'm going to let them introduce themselves.
Hi, everybody. How you doing? My name is Maddie Gervais. I'm actually Mikey's brother. We were born and raised right here in Seattle, Washington. I grew up going to the aquarium and loving it, so I'm happy to be here. And when I'm not playing drums with Mikey and the Rad Scientists, I play guitar and sing in another band called The Head and the Heart.
My name is John Pontrello, and my favorite instrument to play is the harp. And my favorite sea creature is the octopus. And I always thought it would be cool if you could teach an octopus to play the harp, because they have so many arms.
Oh, that's a great idea. I'd love to see that.
I love it.
Excellent. Now, Mikey, New Year's Eve, I think of resolutions. People like to make resolutions. I don't really like to do that. Do you like to make resolutions? There's a lot of pressure.
I usually get as far as like thinking about what resolutions I'd like to make, and yeah. That's usually good enough for me.
Yeah, me too, actually.
I'm planning on going to the aquarium more.
Nice.
That's the best plan right there. Yeah, I like it.
Love it.
I think it's good to have a fresh start for the new year. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely, absolutely.
And yeah. With fresh starts, you know, a lot of self-care. That's a good thing to do. Well-being is really important. We have a lot of care we give our animals here, and care for ourselves. And one thing that makes me feel better is music. It really relaxes me, and it gets me moving. How about you?
Oh, me too. And I love to incorporate movement into a lot of my music. In fact, a song that I was thinking about playing today, maybe you'll want to play along. It has a lot of movement. It goes through the salmon life cycle. And as you know, salmon start out as eggs. So why doesn't everybody become a little egg?
Right. Are you going to choreograph something?
You know, I am an amateur choreographer.
Okay, let's do it. I love it. Let me see.
All right. So everybody at home, become a little egg, all right? And get as small as you can, all right? And then imagine that you're hatching, and you're going to move to the next stage of the salmon life cycle, which is the alevin. So the alevin have these big egg yolks attached to them. So put out your egg yolks, all right? So there's your next move. And then those egg yolks disappear, and they turn into tiny little fries. So you can put your little fins out and swim around like a tiny, tiny little fry, small fish.
Aww.
They get bigger and bigger and bigger, and then they turn into smolts. And smolts are kind of like the teenagers of the salmon world. So you can kind of like maybe take a selfie. And that can be your move for this one. And then they move out into the big ocean and become adults. So you're going to want to chomp as many fish as you can when you're an adult salmon, because you're trying to grow as big as you can, as fast as you can. So that's your move for when you're an adult. And then, finally, you're going to move back into the stream that you were born in, and you're going to wiggle your tail and dig a little nest, and then lay your eggs, and the whole life cycle starts all over again. So wow. How does that sound, Diana?
That sounds complicated, actually.
A little bit, but I think you'll get it.
Okay.
This is a song called Samantha Salmon. Samantha Salmon started out as an egg in a river nest. 3,000 other eggs, but you know she wanted to be the best. After 55 days in water, cold, clean, and clear, she laughed and knew her next life cycle stage was here. But she had been an egg, but now she was an alevin.
Started out as an egg, then became an alevin.
Being an alevin must be really sweet.
you're safe in the gravel and you've always got something to eat. Yeah, that leftover yogurt kept her fed, no doubt. But after three more months, she knew it would run out. The next stage of her life was to be a little fry. Hired out as an egg, then became an elephant. She became a fry. Took a gulp of air and filled up her swim bladder. And started eating lots of bugs so that she could get stronger and fatter. She memorized the smell of the stream she lived in. And then her next life cycle stage could begin, where fresh water meets the salt. Samantha was now a smolt. Started out as an egg, then became an elephant, then became a fry, and now she's a small. Samantha found herself in the estuary and ate as much as she could to be as big as she could be. Her color changed and she was silvery, and she swam out into the sea. She took one more glance back at her home stream. She was no longer a smolt. She was finally an adult. Samantha Salmon was feeling free, and she got the notion to swim for 4 whole years and see lots of the ocean. She ate lots of fish and had lots of fun. Then something in her said that it was time to spawn. Her biggest challenge yet was upon her, 'cause now she was a spawner. Egg, elephant, fry, small, a dough, spawner. Samantha found herself by the smell and the sun, to the little river where her life had begun. She carefully dug a new red with her tail, and laid her eggs with the milk from a male. Though her life cycle was done, a new one had begun. A new
workout and very fun. Your choreography was fabulous. Thank you for doing that.
Thank you.
I think I'm ready to take on 2023. What about you?
I'm feeling pretty good. Yeah.
You're feeling pretty good? Yeah. Awesome. Well, the timer is ticking and I'm excited because we're going to talk to one of our bird and mammal team members about one of our beloved animals here, Barney, our elderly harbor seal. Such a gentleman. He's born and raised here. He's had a lot of great veterinary care and just a lot of love. And when I say old and elderly, he's 37 years old. That's about the equivalent of being a 90-year-old man. And he's just chilling. He takes it easy. I want to talk to Aubrey. Aubrey, how you doing? Happy New Year's Eve.
Happy New Year's. We're here with our harbor seals, Barney, Casey, and Hogan. As you've heard, Barney is our old man of the group. At 37 years old, he gets the best care here at the Seattle Aquarium. We make sure that every day we brush his teeth, maybe even give him a little bit of a gum massage. We weigh him every week. We also pay attention to Barney to see if he's extra hungry or maybe not at all, so we adjust his diet. Every day we also take care of him by examining his body. We just ask him to lay down or roll over, and we take our hands and we touch him, his front flippers, his rear flippers. We look at his eyes just to make sure that there's no bumps, cuts, scratches, and if there are, then we just take care of him. Not only do we give great care to Barney, but we give great care to his roommates as well, Casey and Hogan. Every day we provide them with enrichment, so anything that may stimulate natural behaviors or might just be fun. We give them piles of ice cubes that they love to roll around in and chomp on. Casey's favorite enrichment lately has been hard hats, where he'll carry them all around his habitat. Another cool fact is that they love to take naps underwater. Harbor seals can take naps for up to 30 minutes and hold their breath the whole entire time. Barney especially loves to take naps underwater. He has a favorite large rock that he lays next to in his habitat and will snooze for that long 30 minutes. Our harbor seals at midnight would be laying on deck next to each other in a specific area where they have all their mats laid down, almost like a bed. Barney, specifically, would probably be snoozing through midnight while Hogan and Casey are up and alert and watching some fireworks. Come see Barney at the Seattle Aquarium. Back to you, Diana.
Thanks, Aubrey. That was such great information. I just love learning more things about our harbor seals. And really good that this is noon years, so Barney doesn't have to stay up to midnight, so he can keep sleeping. But you know, Mikey, I don't know if you've ever seen a harbor seal when they're moving on land. It's a little different than their graceful moves underwater.
Oh yeah, I've mostly just seen them kind of laying there basking in the sunshine.
Oh, like when they're in their big cuddle piles all together, just resting. Yeah,
so cute.
They're really graceful underwater, very efficient swimmers. But on land, a little different, a little awkward, a little roly-poly, kind of like an inchworm. It actually might be kind of a funny dance to do.
Oh, there. I would love to see like what you come up with.
Okay,
yeah.
Well, I was thinking about that inchworm. They kind of undulate their body and move it like a wave, kind of like
that. Cool.
And let's see, they like, oh, I forgot to say, amazing whiskers. So we can make their whiskers move around in the water because you know what? Their whiskers are more sensitive than your dog or your cat's. They can detect fish from very far away in the dark, murky waters of the Salish Sea. So we could be swimming like this, like a wave. We could have our very sensitive whiskers feeling around, sensing fish. And they also do a lot of rolling around on the ground. I don't know.
Oh, yeah, you gotta do it, yeah.
Really? Okay. So everybody out there, if you have some space in your area, ta-da!
Oh, that's amazing.
Oh, goodness.
Yeah, no, I'd totally do that, too, but I have this guitar, so I think I better stay standing.
I'll see what I can do. Like, if I can do that during the dance, but I might need help getting up at the end of it. So, yeah, do you have a song that we could do for this?
As a matter of fact, we do. It's called Harbor Seal.
Okay.
And it goes a little something like this.
Swam loop to loops and played hide and seek.
dancing, Diana.
Incredible.
You went there. You went all the way.
Okay.
Nice job.
Oh my gosh, I love the harbor seals so much, and I love that they participate in their own health care. And we're going to learn more from our own veterinarian, Dr. Caitlin. She spoke with us earlier this year about our brand new vet clinic.
I'm Caitlin Hadfield. I'm the senior veterinarian at the Seattle Aquarium. So this is called a wet table. This is a piece of equipment that we didn't have access to before, and it's really helpful when you're dealing with aquatic animals. So things like fish, our seabirds, and our sea otters, this table lets us work with water in a way that we didn't used to be able to do before. Because we work with fish and sea turtles and things like that in here, we want to have easy access to the water that they rely on. So we've actually plumbed in our salt water and our fresh water so that if we need to change out water for the animals, we can do that really easily. And they put in really, really big pipes, so it comes out extremely fast. Recently, we did some routine exams on our wrymouth, which is a very cool bottom-dwelling fish. It's like a giant blenny. And that animal was in here for a little while, so we wanted to give it some fresh water, some new salt water. And so we're able to use those lines to change out the water as we need to. We use this all the time. It's actually really useful for our aquatic species. It is an ultrasound machine, and what's exciting about it is it's a big tower right now, but the top bit that looks like a laptop we can actually bring with us into animal habitat. So sometimes we'll use this here and just wheel it over to the table. You'll see all of our equipment here is on wheels, which is very helpful. And then sometimes we'll just take the laptop out, put it in a secure box, and take it out to the animals, and then do the ultrasounds with them in their habitat, just under their full cooperation. This came up pretty early in the design plans because we wanted to share what we do for animal care, both with our visitors, but also even with our staff and volunteers. We've never been able to do that before because we've been very space limited. And so this gives us opportunities we've never had, and we're excited to learn how to use this as best as possible to really showcase what we do here.
Oh yeah, thanks for telling us all about that. I am so excited about that vet clinic because of that window that you can actually look in and you can see animals getting checkups. I've even seen the wolf eels get checkups. I've seen the diving birds get weighed. It's amazing. And another thing that's amazing is we actually do surgery on fishes here sometimes. So even before we had the vet clinic, over 10 years ago, we have two fishes that had eye surgery. They live right here in our Window on Washington Waters exhibit, our yellow-eyed rockfishes Rock and Roll. And we have our divers, and they're swimming with them right now. Hi, divers.
Hi, everyone. I'm Diver Andy.
Hello, everyone. I'm Diver Nicole. It is so good to see you all today.
Diana, we just heard you talking about some of our amazing rockfish in here. Mm-hmm. And just a moment ago, as we were getting ready to dive, we heard an amazing song about another fabulous resident of this habitat.
Yes, you did. You heard a song about our salmon, our really shiny, silvery fast fish in this exhibit.
Oh, I love those salmon. They have those beautiful, shiny scales. I think of salmon as swimming disco balls. And those reflective scales, they just shimmer in the light. That can be an important part of their camouflage for predators like the orca whale. And those shimmery, silvery scales make it difficult for a predator to tell one salmon apart from another when they're swimming together or schooling. So there's protection in numbers.
These salmon are so beautiful and shimmery and shiny. And all the rockfish in here really bring the color to this underwater party. Rockfish and salmon have a lot of differences between them. For example, rockfish scales are big and heavy, like a suit of armor. And you might see a whole lot of different kinds or species of rockfish in here. Lots of them have the same body shape, but they might be showing off different colors or patterns. Something else that's special about rockfish is that they tend to hang out near the bottom part of this habitat. They are often found sitting on rocks, holding still like rocks, even sometimes looking like rocks. Gosh, I wonder how how they got that name, rockfish.
I wonder, Annie. It's true, those rockfish are the residents of the rocky reef, while the salmon spend more of their time near the surface. They really use that beautiful canopy of bull kelp as a highway, a place to protect themselves as they travel from one place to another. And salmon are always on the move. This is the time of year when we're seeing salmon passing right by the Seattle Aquarium's pier. They're on the search for abundant food like krill and smaller fish, and salmon are always hungry.
Well, krill is no meal for a rockfish. I mean, just look at those huge mouths. They eat much bigger prey, and they're not gonna find it up at the surface. That's why we often see rockfish hanging out a little lower down in the water here. And here at the Seattle Aquarium, we feed whole anchovy, clams, and prawns to our rockfish.
Our rockfish really are the homebodies of the Pacific Northwest. We can go to the same rocky reef year after year after year when we're doing research here at the aquarium. And we might see the same exact rockfish time and again. In fact, when you come to visit us here at the Seattle Aquarium, you might notice the same rockfish in the same area of this habitat. And that's not just because they're the homebodies of the rocky reef. They also live a long time.
It's true, rockfish live quite a while. Our friends the salmon pack a whole lot of life into just 3 to 5 years. And in that life cycle, they might travel hundreds of miles as they're hatched in freshwater rivers, travel all the way down here to the salty ocean, and then all the way back again up to their home rivers. Rockfish live here in the ocean their entire lives, and it sure can be a long one. In fact, we have a few rockfish in here with us now, Nicole, who are in their 60s, and their names are Rock and Roll.
Oh, I am so excited to introduce you all to our celebrities, Rock and Roll. They are the large yellow-eyed rockfish that are in that dusky orange color. The male, his name is Roll, and the female, she's the Rock. Now, both Rock and Roll, wait a second. Did you say that they're about 60 years old now?
Absolutely. These two fish have been here at the Seattle Aquarium for quite some time, and based off of their size, we estimate that those fish are over 60 years old. Now, a lot of rockfish species can live to be 100 years or more, and yellow-eye rockfish, like our friends Rock and Roll, can live to be about 140 years old. And that means Rock and Roll get to look forward to many more fun New Year's Eves.
Oh, that is amazing. Rock and Roll certainly are the rock stars of the show today. But I think that our salmon are ready for a New Year's celebration too. But we're gonna need a real disco ball. Let's show them some moves.
Thank you, divers. That was so great. I get blown away by one of the things you said about the age difference, that salmon maybe only live 3 to 5 years and rockfish perhaps over 100 years old. I mean, that is incredible. And also you talked about how beautiful and colorful the rockfish are. They're kind of the colors of all the different colors in the rainbow. But I think salmon, being all flashy and silver, are like the glam rockers of the sea. So we've got our Rock and Roll rockfish, our glam rockers of the sea. And Mikey, I was thinking, you know, we have our old moves. We have our dance from the past New Year's Eves of rockfishes. And then we have our salmon from today.
Whoa, should we combine them?
I think It's never been done before.
It's never been done. Okay, we gotta try it.
we gotta try a combined
salmon slash rockfish dance?
It might be complicated, but we can do it. I think we can do it.
I think we can do it. But you know, Andy wasn't here last year, so maybe we should teach her the dance moves too?
Yeah, definitely. Andy and anybody out there who wants to learn it again, let's have a little refresher.
Right.
So our rockfish, we have our gills on either side of our fishy face. You can even puck your lips if you want to. And we have their spiky dorsal fin that's on the top of their back. And then we also have their caudal fin or their tail fin, which they'll swish back and forth to maneuver around in the ocean. And then all those salmon moves we learned earlier. Mikey, are you ready to take us into this dance?
All right, let's do it. I'm a rock fish, swimming deep down by the rocks. I'm a rock fish, I'm the coolest fish on the block. And if you met me, how about that? Well, you'd help protect my habitat. 'Cause we are one, the rock fish, and my rocky home is where it's at. I'm a rock fish, swimming in the deep blue sea. I'm a rock fish. Have you ever met a fish like me? 'Cause if you met me, you'd say, hey, let's protect these special fish today. 'Cause we all want the rock fish to keep on rocking in the rocks of the bay. But there's the yellow eye and the deacon, tiger, china, canary. There's so many beautiful rockfish swimming in the Salish Sea. And if you met me, you'd say, hey, let's protect these special fish today. 'Cause we all want the rockfish to keep on rocking in the rocks of the bay. Like me, and if you met me, you'd say, hey, let's protect these special fish today. 'Cause we all want the rockfish to keep on rocking in the rocks of the bay. Yes, we all want the rockfish to keep on rocking in the rocks of the bay.
That song. Mikey, every time you play it, I just want a boogie. That song is so fun to dance to, especially when we are hanging out with salmon and rockfish. But oh my gosh, y'all, look at the time. I think we need to start counting down.
Okay, it is that time, everybody. Oh my gosh, is everybody ready here? You got your hands up, ready to count? People out in the audience, hands up and
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Happy New Year, everybody!
To all the rockfish in the sea, and to each and everyone, we wish you Happy New Year's Eve. Now that 22 is done. Happy New Year!
I think it's probably about time for us to get onto dry land again.
Really? So soon? I want to dance some more.
Yeah, you all can come get out of the water and come join us for later dancing and music. We'd love to have you.
Really?
Of course,
you can?
Yes, you can.
That would be wonderful. Oh, we better
check it out now. We'll be back soon.
All right, we'll see you in a little bit. Go warm up. While we wait for our divers to get out, I am so excited to talk with our next guest, Brian, and he's going to tell us about our new Ocean Pavilion that's opening in 2024, and we're going to have all these new tropical animals. It's really exciting. So, hey, Brian, how's it going? Happy New Year's.
Like they were saying, I have this wonderful opportunity of working with lots of new animals that are coming to the Seattle Aquarium, as well as some that have been with us for quite some time. One of the first animals to arrive at the Animal Care Center were goatfish. It's a schooling fish that have an adaptation on their chin, things called barbels, and they can move them around. And what they use them for is sifting through sand, trying to find food so they can eat. Some of the new animals we have at the Animal Care Center are various species of rays that flap their pectoral fins like this, while we have some bottom-dwelling rays that move their pectoral fins like this in order to move around. And we can't forget our plants that we have here at the Animal Care Center. Over here, we have mangroves that we're going to be showcasing at the Ocean Pavilion. Mangroves are an important part of the ecosystem in that they create various habitats for small animals like fish to grow. It's a place for adults to lay eggs or have their babies. Little ones grow up inside these mangroves, and then they are able to either stay there or move out onto the reef. Mangroves, being a plant, also need a lot of water. And since they're in the ocean, they get plenty of that. But salt will actually build up inside the roots, and that's a little bit too much for them. So what they'll actually do is excrete or spit out salt through their leaves. And you can sometimes see a little dusting of salt on their leaves. All the animals and plants we've been talking about live in the Coral Triangle. And at midnight, the animals of the Coral Triangle are going to be doing different things. Some of them are going to be going to bed, like the goatfish, finding habitat for them to sleep through the night, while others are going to be partying out, like the corals, where they're going to be letting out their tentacles and trying to feed on the plankton that might be there. No matter what's going on in the Coral Triangle, there's always a party. While you can't see these animals in person yet, it's been really fun showing you some small glimpses into what we're doing at the Animal Care Center. Stay tuned, because soon there's going to be some more opportunities to learn about what we're doing here. Happy New Year's. Back to you, Diana.
Thank you so much, Brian. That was great. And divers, come on in. Thanks for joining us.
Oh, thank you for having us.
Awesome. How's it going?
We're doing really well. Thank
Excellent.
You.
Excellent. All right.
It was so wonderful to hear from Brian. The goatfish, the rays, the mangroves. There's so much happening at the Animal Care Center.
Yep.
And even the corals that you all met at New Year's last year, they live at the Animal Care Center now as well.
I know, it was just so cool to get a little glimpse into the behind the scenes.
I have to say, you must be feeling inspired now. I mean, talk about goatfish mm-hmm. and rays. Do you have some dance moves for us?
Of course I do.
All right.
Goatfish are really cool. They've got these barbels under their chin. We can do these little barbels, like a little beard that can detect food and prey under the sand. So we can do this. Sparkle fingers, everybody. Sparkle fingers. And we can also do rays with their big pectoral fins that make them look like they're flying underwater. So gorgeous. And then those trees, those mangrove trees, which have amazing root systems that are above ground. And I don't know, Nicole, do you think you, and Andy, everybody, people out there, can you do the tree out there?
Let's try it. Okay. I love the mangrove tree.
Mikey,
nice.
Can you do it while you're playing guitar?
I can give it a shot.
Okay, I want to see that, everybody. Let's see what this goes like.
Let's try it.
Hit it.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
Mangrove, mangrove. Come on and sing a little mangrove song with me. Mangrove, mangrove. So much depends upon a happy, healthy mangrove tree. Mangrove, mangrove. Come on and sing a little mangrove song with me. Mangrove, mangrove. So much depends upon a happy, healthy mangrove tree. Out of all the plants, you probably stop erosion the most, 'cause you can grow in salty places where the other plants can't. and you stop the currents carrying away all the sand. A big strong hurricane battering the shoreline. Mangrove roots are holding on and breaking the waves. Hard rain falling, fast wind blowing. Mangroves help to keep the beach from washing away. Mangrove, mangrove, come on and sing a little mangrove song with me. Mangrove, mangrove, so much depends upon a happy, healthy mangrove tree. You're the safest place for lots of little fishes to hatch, 'cause they can hide in your roots where they're so hard to catch. You're home to so many birds and invertebrates, and to oh so, so, so many fish. Like the mangrove lip ray gliding through the water, looking for a crunchy, cool crustacean to eat. Or the rainbow parrotfish born in the mangrove, grazing on the algae, keeping corals clean. Mangrove, mangrove, come on and sing a little mangrove song with me. Mangrove, mangrove, so much depends upon a happy, healthy mangrove tree. Sea for miles around, the influence of the mangrove forest can be found. In this way, the mangrove forest is a nursery that's protecting tropical marine diversity. There goes a baby barracuda hiding in the roots, chomping fish until it's big enough to swim out to sea. Thousands of species, billions of animals, depending on the health of the mangrove tree. Mangrove, mangrove, come on and sing a little mangrove song with me. Mangrove, mangrove, so much depends upon a happy, healthy mangrove tree. Mangrove, mangrove, come on and sing a little mangrove song with me. On a happy, healthy mangrove tree. Mangrove, mangrove, come on and sing a little mangrove song with me.
Wow, that was more of a workout than the first dance. Who knew a mangrove dance would be so exhausting? But guess what, team? It's time to say goodbye.
Aww. No, yeah. I'm sad that it's coming to an end.
Yeah, me too. Mm. Me too. But I just want to make sure to thank everybody who was involved in our New Year's Eve celebration. The audience, you out there dancing, singing with us, thank you so much. Our animal care people here, Aubrey and Brian, Dr. Caitlin, our veterinarian, our fabulous divers, we got Nicole and Andy, thanks for joining us. And of course, last but not least, our amazing band, Mikey and the Rad Scientist. Thanks, Mikey.
Thank you. That was so much fun.
So, Mikey, if the audience wants to hear more of your tunes or learn a bit more about you, where should they go?
So anywhere on the internet, you can look for Mikey the Rad Scientist, and you'll find us there. Actually, we'll have a link to our website right there below in the chat. So go ahead and click that and come say hi on the internet.
And I want to say hello again out there to Jasmine. We miss you. I can't wait to dance with you again. And to all of you out there, do like and subscribe our pages. You'll get to see a lot of information about all the changes that are occurring down here and all the interesting little glimpses into the Animal Care Center. There's a lot to learn, and we can't wait to see you in the new year. Everybody, just thank you so much. See you soon.
So Samantha found her way by the smell and the sun to the little river where her life had begun. She carefully dug a new red with her tail and laid her eggs with the milk from a male, though her life cycle was done.